cervical cancer. The great news is slowly but surely heading for elimination, at least in the US. There have been 15,000 new cases in 2021. It's a very small percentage of all cancers now, less than 1%. The incidence of it has declined by 50% between 1975 and 2010. The backbone of screening is pap smear and HPV typing. And the future really looks positive for elimination of cervical cancer thanks to HPV immunization. So all cervical cancer is caused by human papillomavirus, known as HPV, virtually all. Risks are directly related to your level of exposure, and there's greater than 100 types of HPV. This can get confusing, but you don't have to know about all those types because there are only about 4 to 6 that are really related to cervical cancer. The majority of people are exposed in over a lifetime to the human papillomavirus, and the majority of us clear it without any symptoms or even knowledge that we were ever exposed. Other risks that are distinct are smoking, HIV positivity, a history of multiple sexual partners, and use of birth control pills for prolonged years can all increase a woman's risk for cervical cancer. Next slide. So there are some very straightforward recommendations. The American Cancer Society recently updated their recommendations, the US Preventive Services Task Force, and those two bodies are pretty much those that people pay attention to in terms of cervical screening. And there's not a lot of discrepancy between these recommendations. The cornerstone is a PAP and an HPV test, which are done at the same time, at the same visit, every 5 years, once you've reached age 30, and somewhere between every 3 or 5 years, depending on the recommender, younger than that. We do not screen young women anymore under the age of 21, even if they are sexually active. And it's because it's become clear that though you can be exposed and show positivity for HPV, the vast majority of us clear the virus on our own. We stop screening women at age 65 or older if they've had a history of normal tests and are not at high risk. And this is just a summary, again, of the US Preventive Services Task Force. So I want to emphasize that the real future and excitement about eliminating cervical cancer is rooted in HPV immunization, which has been around now for 15 plus years. Generally, we start talking to parents and kids between 11 and 12. 2 doses. When given between the ages of 9 and 14, 3 doses if given older. It's been approved for up to age 26. And most states cover the immunization when it's given to preteens. There is a lot of variation between how states pay for immunization for older people, those between 18 and 26. So it's valuable to know in your state when the coverage occurs. And as I mentioned, there is a real promise within the world of cervical cancer for the elimination of cervical cancer because of that vaccine.